Greetings, everybody. Welcome back to my Let's Play of Mega Man 7 for the Super NES. In the last part, we finished up the first stage of Wily's Castle, and now we're going to Stage 2. Stage 2 is one of my least favorites, mainly because of the boss. I mean, it's a fairly easy stage, but the boss is a bitch. Fly up here and destroy all these things. What I love about the S-Adept upgrade is that it homes in on enemies. And it does quite a bit of damage, especially to those jerks. I avoid that life down there if I don't need it. Can only hit those guys when their backs are turned. Go up this ladder. Find another one of these jerks. And that's just an extra life, just sitting there like, hey, how's it going? So I run over there to grab it. Destroy that guy. Go up here. Now here, I save state. That's a good thing I do, because I ended up dying once. Because this battle is kind of tough if you don't know what to use. It's time the mighty Mega Man shall fall. Treble attack! I save state there again, thinking I'm gonna lose again. That way I don't have to listen to that whole blah 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 shit over again. Now this guy has no real pattern. He's just a bitch to beat. So he likes to hit you a lot. Especially with those damn guns. Oh lord, I hate those. Excuse me, why are you hitting me? Why? Why can't I destroy him? Cause I'm the good guy, okay? That's why. And you're a dick. Okay? Alright, second half of the stage, you gotta put up with this jerk. I don't know why I bother even killing him, but I do. All I get is a little bitty bolt. This part gives me such a hard friggin' time. I couldn't jump to save my damn life here. It was ridiculous. I end up falling here in a minute. It's ridiculous, because of that damned frog. Yeah, I'm now gonna go all the way back up. And the frogs respawn. Oh. Anyways. What's been going on with everybody? For me here lately, I haven't been doing a whole lot of much of anything. Except talking to my adopted internet sister on Skype for hours at a time. Oh, I hate this part. These fire flamethrowers, I'm gonna call them. I was gonna say fire blowers, but flamethrower just sounds better. I could have got that life over there. I didn't even see that. Good lord. Now these guys, I thought there was no way to kill them, but there is. It's the danger rep. That's the only thing that can hit them, I think. But the only thing about that is if you hit one and it doesn't blow up right away, you have to wait for it before you can even fire another one. I hate this room. I mean, it doesn't look that difficult, but it's horrible. And that jerk hit me somehow. I get hit way more than I need to. I thought I was gonna die there for sure. If only there was a way to freeze those, but there's not. Okay, this boss. I hate it. Such a slow freaking fight. Probably because it's a turtle. Now, it's weak to the wild coil. But hitting it while it's breathing fire can be kind of difficult. I have to slide under him or he's gonna hit you. I think I do take a hit from him that way. Now, for this part, I use the slash claw because these things are easier to take one hit from the slash claw. I think just about anything else will take a few hits. I quickly switch back to- I switched the wrong weapon. Whoops. Oof. I think that's the only hit I take here. too slow on my delivery there, but what I like about these guys, they drop life and weapon energy if you need it. Right back to the wild coil. I end up hitting him twice in one go here, both times. And after every two rotations of his attack, this guy's very simple attack pattern. He'll shoot fire at you, jump over it, then he'll charge you god knows how many times. Then after that one, he'll release his turtles. The turtles do different things, but I don't let them stay alive long enough to figure out what they do. The fire will steadily do damage, which is a bit annoying. And the turtle is down. I hate that boss. It's so freaking slow. I think that's its only weakness, too, is the wild coil. I'm not sure. Blip, 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 blip. Password, blah, 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 blah. Joyous. Alright, now that we are done with stage 2. Gonna pay a visit to Otto. I'm gonna show off what Otto can do. Hey! That's my bolt! Thanks, it fits perfectly. He'll screw in his bolt, which is ridiculously cute. I don't know why, it just is. He looks so pro. Now I can work at full power, which means double the speed as it was before. Look, a new item just for you. I can now make items using half the normal number of bolts. Awesome. Select the item you want to make. Or you want made, whatever. Of course, you have an extra life. An E-can, an energy tank, whatever you want to call it. Weapons, tank, W-can. It enables you to exit from the stage if... you've already defeated the robot boss. We already have that. We found that in Freeze Man stage. This is Beat's Whistle. You cannot buy these if you have not freed Beat, so they're pretty much pointless. S-cans are awesome. It fully charges your special, your energy, and all your weapons. Rush Jet, we already have it. We found that in Junkman stage. Rush Search, we found that in Freeze Man's level 1. What is this called? The Energy Equalizer. Hey, I was right. What do you know? Holy shit, I was right about something. OMG, no way. And what it does, basically, I already explained it, but this is the Hyper Rocket Buster. 800 bolts? Are you joking? Enables the Rocket Buster to go further and to home in on enemies. You forgot something, Otto. I know something you don't. This is a 1-up. It gives you an extra man's. And for some reason, my dumbass buys one, because I pushed the wrong button. So long, Mega Man. I thought the start button would throw you back to the enemy select screen, but no, he's like, oh, I want to make an item now. It's like, god damn it. But yeah, you saw how fast I got that 1-up. So it was nice. It was rather nice. Alright, see, as you saw on the map, the stage has two ways you can go. I will be showing off both ways you can go. I love the music in this little stage, stage 3. I love it. It's just catchy. I love it. It's cool. Junk shield here. I don't know why, but it actually serves me pretty damn good. And I get some lag when I jump across this hole. I thought I was gonna die for sure. Oy! Epic slowdown. Ended up cutting there because I ended up miscalculating this jump and dying. Although it may not have looked like it, but I did. That actually came came out really good in editing. Wow. I'm proud of myself. Alright. This jerk. I kill him just to get him out of the damn way. Excuse me. Extra mans. I think the max you can have is 9. I don't know. I've never really cared to look. I get these jerks, and you got the springs. If you hit the spring, it's probably gonna knock you back into a spikes and kill you. So that's why S Adept is your best friend for that part. Alright, this section right here is where I was telling you it has two ways you can go. I will be coming back to this once we get to the place where these two areas meet. So, for the first part, you stay up top. I thought you were supposed to slide on that wall, but apparently you can just stand on that one and go across. I almost fell there, that would have sucked. This part I save state because I don't trust my jumping, and you can't really get across that by just jumping anyway. I ended up dying here in the next part, so I thought I could rush jet across, and failed miserably. Good thing I kind of didn't go all the way across, though, because I would have missed something that's very nice up ahead. A free energy tank, a weapon can, and an S-can. ESW. Alright, now I got this jackass in my way. Excuse me. I tried to just jump, go take a hit and go through him, but anyway, there's where the boss room is, so I'll see you back in a sec. Alright, there we are. Hey, I remember this part. Now we're just gonna take the bottom path. The bottom path is a lot less forgiving. At a different time as my other one, and I thought I could get up there with Rush Coil, but apparently I could not. So, whatever. I jumped down here, miscalculated, ended up dead. Didn't save state. I was like, where's it gonna load me at? Well, it loaded me right there, which is perfect. This is where I was to begin with. I think if you die in the upper area, you're gonna, start back there and have to take the bottom path anyway, but I didn't die on that top part, so I'm not entirely sure. And since the game screwed me out of a life, I'm taking that one. Alright. These jerks underwater. Yeah. You will fight a familiar mini-boss here. Hey! I remember you. I just end up pelting him with my... take a couple hits, but that's okay. I like shooting bubbles. He likes bubbles. I run over there. Good thing I do. It drops a life. I end up dying on the way up the first time. Because I stayed to the left, and you'll see what happens if you stay to the left. Yeah, it traps you and ends up killing you. Just not pleasant. Good thing I safe stayed after I beat that guy. I don't know why I get this. I don't need it. I'm an idiot, I know. Can I say? Ah, what the hell? Oh, there it goes. I attempt to take out this jerk. He ends up going out of sight and out of mind. Okay. Alright. Here we are. We are back. So, those are the two paths you can take. If you can get to the top area, for God's sake, do it. I don't remember which boss it is, so... As soon as I enter the room, I'm like, oh yeah, this guy. This guy's a dick. I don't like this guy. The only way you can hit him is in the eyes. What you're supposed to do is jump on those missiles and jump up and hit him. Watch out for the laser. It will hurt. But if he's floating low enough and at the peak of your jump, you can slash him. I take a couple unnecessary hits here, but I still win, dammit. Whee! One more hit, and he is dead. And that is it for Wily Stage 3. I think I'm gonna cut it here. So, next time on Mega Man 7, we will be taking on Wily Stage 4 and hopefully finishing up this game. I will catch you guys later.